Oh, what that mouth do. Baby, you eat, drink. I can whistle a little bit and I talk shit. That's it. Cause see, wait, now listen, everybody. It's Sweet Baby Red on the ones, twos, threes, fours, fives, and sixes. And I'm back like crack with another video. Back with another one, back with another one, back with another. Anyways, anyhow. So this video, as you could tell by the title, that I'm gonna be sharing with y'all my bedtime thoughts. You know my thoughts that I be having when I'm in bed by myself, lonely. Yeah, you know, with the lights off, you know, pitch black completely, no sound, naked. That's the best way to sleep. That's the only way. Well, actually, it's a mix of that. You know, my mind after midnight, mind at midnight, or whatever. A mix of unpopular opinions and things that I wanna say and I'm gonna say because I can't say it. Right, you drink a point out. Let's get straight into the video because I ain't got much time, I ain't got much storage, much space, baby. If you are this able, please don't act able. Because my thing is this, I hate that, because I feel like some people out there, they use their disability to an advantage. Like Roland Ray, for example. Y'all see him on TV. No shade to Roland Ray, cool. Like, I over there, I don't know him in real life. And I feel like he using what he got to his advantage. Me personally, conversation with him and Bobby Light. How he just rolled up all of Bobby Light's face. Talking crazy, and Bobby was like, oh, get him out of my face, get him out of my face. Oh, baby, one thing about me, I don't need no help. I don't need no, boop, you feel me? Bop, you feel me? Because one thing about it, like, I'm over here minding my business, you over there. Don't cruise control your way over here to my face. One, two, talking crazy. I don't do no shit like that. And then how he was on, him and Bobby had that show together, he was on a running folks over. Baby, bloop, I'm knocking the juice out the motherfucker's seat, and I'm cutting the cord. I hope you ain't got nowhere to go. I'ma say this and I'ma leave it here. One thing I do not like hearing is it take a man to kill somebody. No, it don't. Come on, think of this. I feel like you gotta be scary to actually, well, it depends on circumstances. You know, some men, you know, might be protecting their family. Some people might mess with you first. You know, it might be, excuse me. It might be self-defense. You know, anything good that come with it, you know, y'all think about it. I don't really care to think about it. I'm not gonna lie. I don't understand people who like to run their mouth and then run to a gun, run to a weapon. Why are you talking tough if you not tough? Babe, you softer than the inside of an UGG boot, yet you still wanna steal, you wanna talk shit, you wanna start drama, but when the person pricks you, you run to a gun. I seen this video, these folks that was playing basketball, and it was a tall dude and a short dude. Short was calling tall a bitch, and tall was like, oh, I'm not no bitch. Short was like, you is a bitch. And then tall said, call me a bitch again. Short did it, and tall hit him. Short went to his truck for the gun. Who really a bitch? You're gonna point out, and I really wouldn't give two fucks or a damn how you dress it up or how you dress it down. Oh, I'm too rich to fight. I don't got time to fight. I didn't buy this gun. What you think I bought this gun for? I didn't buy it for no reason. I know you ain't buy it for no reason. You bought it because you a bitch. You a bitch. You know what I'm saying? Let's call a spade a spade. Let's call a duck a duck. Let's call Monday Monday, Tuesday Tuesday, Wednesday Wednesday, and let's call a bitch. You a bitch, and that's okay. Ray J said he had one wish, but he asked for 13 things. Why is your song called One Wish if you're not asking for one thing? Your song should have been called 13 Wishes. So Ray J said, and I quote, if I had one wish, we would be best friends. That's one. Love would never end. That's two. It would just begin. That's three. If I had one wish, you would be my boo. That's four. Promise to love you. That's five. Trust me, I trust you. That's six. If I had one wish, we would run away. That's seven. Make it love all day. That's eight. Have us a bag. That's nine. If I had one wish, I'd make it my whole life. That's ten. It'll be my wife. That's make it right this time. That's okay, he didn't ask for 13 wishes. He didn't ask for 13 things. He asked for 12 things. Ray J, why is your song not called 12 Wishes? That's not one wish, Ray J. That's a Christmas list. That's like you only get three wishes with a genie. The genie, you know what I'm saying? You ran out. You want nine too many wishes. You're going to point out, and by the name of your song, you want a little too many wishes. Who lied to Tamar? Right? Who lied to Tamar? Y'all never think about that? Like, who went out their way to go lie to Tamar and feed her these lies? You know, that's false advertisement. That's false hope. Somebody said every day it was going to be sunny skies. Only lingerie and Marvin Gaye. I guess somebody lied. Why would y'all do that to Tamar? She didn't deserve that. She went into love blind because of you, bitch. And I, sorry. Don't lie to Tamar. That's what I'm saying. When you get your heart broken by a boy, you know, you get your little feelings hurt. Why the bitches automatically start complimenting you on your looks?
Oh. You're beautiful. You're gorgeous. You He's so pretty, you don't need him.
Bitch. I never said I was ugly. I never said it. I said my heart is hurting. This man cheated on me. I love this man, and he did me wrong. Yeah, I'm pretty, but now what? Exactly, baby. Back up for something happened to you. When it comes to an argument, you gotta think shallow to cut deep. A lot of you bitches, y'all be going above and beyond. Y'all be going far, far, far away with Shrek, Donkey, Fiona, and him. For no reason, it don't take all of that. You gotta think shallow to go deep. The other day, my friend texted me, she was into it with this boy. The boy said something disrespectful. This is an example. She sent me the screenshot, and in the message, in the text box, she said, "Die, you miserable B." She asked me, should she send that? I said, no, don't send that. We don't wish death on people no more. That's not us. What you seeing? You seeing this. I see why your daddy abandoned you. Baby, that's gonna hurt him. That's gonna hurt him. That's gonna hurt more than death. Like, it's true. Your daddy abandoned you. It's true. You didn't have to think too hard. It's gonna hurt him. That's gonna bring up past hurt of so many years. You like what, 21? Your daddy been at the store getting milk for 21 years and some months? That's gonna hurt him. You thinking too deep on it. Just hit him with the truth. Now, it might have been my best friend there, opposed to his. You know what I'm saying? But that's all right. That's fine, you know. A win is a win. You gotta do what you gotta do by you know, any means necessary. Does Georgia call Jeannie Peach because peaches come from Georgia? Me personally, I like DLs. I like DL men. Now, I text both openly gay and DL men from time to time, but it'd be more, so a lot of times I don't text nobody. I'd be ignoring folks. And then when bitches, they'd be like, oh, love yourself, know your worth, you deserve better, you deserve somebody that's gonna show you off. My thing is this, I don't wanna be shown off. I'm not looking for no relationship, and just because I'm with the DL man don't mean I don't love myself. Some of y'all were openly gay men, and women say it too. Some of y'all were straight men, and y'all don't even love yourselves. He don't love you. He don't love you, and you don't love you. It's not about who you with, whether or not you love yourself. It's about whether or not you love yourself. DL dudes give me the attention that I want. That I want and that I'm looking for. They're gonna give it to me, right? And it's like, I already know that they lying. Oh, I'm gonna come out the closet for you one day. One day we're gonna be together. You know, this, that, the third, fourth, and the fifth. And I'm acting like that I'm buying the lies they're selling you, but the whole time, I'm returning it. I'm selling them the same dream that I think they're selling me. Whole time, I'm not trying to be with this man. I'm just lying. Don't keep you around because I love the attention that you're giving me. Now, mind you, I can't lie to no openly gay man like that. I can't say, oh, one day we're going to be together because then, boom, one thing leads to another, something leads to something else. Boom, he trying to be with me. And I don't want to be with you. Well, I'm taking this one boy that I like. I think I like him way more than he like me, but that's a different story for a different time. And he openly gay. This a different time. I like when wee-wees pop out the drawers, right? You know, like, say you in the room, you know, set the mood, set the tone. You in the room with your man, amen, somebody else man. Hope you can fight if somebody else man. You know, they pulling their boxers down real slow. Real slow, real seductive, real sexy, real cute. Like, now mind y'all, this only work for long wee-wees. This not no short wee-wee sport. You know what I'm saying? Y'all go play with some tweezers or something. Pulling his boxers down. Not too slow, though, because if the wee-wee too long, you do it too slow, I'm going to get bored, right? I'm asleep by the time you're done. But, like, boom, pulling it in at a real nice pace. And you just see the wee-wee just coming out, like, boom, slowly revealing itself. And it's just got a nice color to it. See the bangs in it, and it's nice and thick. Not too thick, but it's thick. You just see it, right? You just looking like you don't know what they expect, but like at the same time, you know what they expect. It's a wee-wee, bitch. But like, you know, it's just building anticipation. So boom, it finally get there. And it just, boom, just, whew. The wee-wee come out, bitch, like it's on hydraulics. Or like, maybe like a door stopper. You know, go like, doing, doing, like a jack in the box. It's just, boom. It's just out. Only pretty wee-wees, though. Only pretty wee-wees. Only long wee-wees. A lot of times, parents have no idea what their kids be doing. No clue at all, bitch. And like I said previously, I was an apartment kid. My mama thought I was outside playing with the kids. You know, playing kickball, football, soccer, at the playground, hide and seek. Whole time, I'm in the woods in the back of the apartment sucking wee wee. Yup. Talking a little too much. I'm just gonna leave them alone. I'm gonna shut up. I'm sprung. Girl, you got me. Got me doing things I never do with you. And then I'm telling you I'm. Got me doing things I never do with you. And then I'm telling you. I'm a sexually active virgin. I'm a sexually active virgin. Like, for real. When they want me, y'all, I talk freaky. I think freaky. I rap freaky. Baby, I probably even walk freaky, baby. You know what I'm saying? But, like, I just love it. You know what I'm saying? Like, I be like, don't ever text my phone talking nasty. Well, I don't do that no more. I used to have real, real freaky fingers type shit, right? I don't know. Something about it's so exhilarating. Like, I can't explain it, but I love talking nasty. Well, I talk nasty to my friends. Like, I don't really talk nasty to, like, dudes no more. I used to. Bitch, I got nasty in a scoop of Black Eyed Peas. But it's like, and the thing is, I won't talk nasty. No, I probably will. And it's gonna sound backwards as fuck, but if I like you, I can't talk nasty to you. Like, I can't make myself do that. But if I don't like you, now you catch me at the right time, I'm bored. Bitch, I'm gonna talk real nasty. I'm gonna get real nasty, bitch. Nastier than Raising Cane's. You're gonna point out nastier than KFC chicken. I try to do it as much because we grown now. You know, dudes gonna be trying to hunch and see what that mouth do for real. Oh, what that mouth do. Baby, you eat, drink, I can whistle a little bit, and I talk shit. That's it. So it's like, I'm gonna leave alone because you text me and it get too real, it get too deep, too fast. You're gonna be left with blue balls and you're gonna be left on red. I'm sorry, I can't do nothing for you. You know what I'm saying? It's a prank, you fell for it. Speaking of punching, do y'all have any, like, sexual fantasies? I got two. One of my sexual fantasies is, like, you know, I'm gonna be on top, I'm gonna be riding a little bit, and, like, you know, I'm just riding real good. I'm from the South, I ride real good, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, boom, you know, you about to finish, right? I wanna grab by his neck and look him in his eyes. And I wanna say, come for me. My second one is, I wanna hunt a dude that know how to sing. And while, you know, we a missionary, or maybe from the back, or whatever, right? Not dog style. Like, he lay on top of me, right? He just slow stroking it. And while he's slow stroking it, whether he a missionary or from the back, he just whispered my ear out and he's singing. I don't know what song he's singing, but while he slow strokes, he just sang it to my ear, bitch. I feel like that's gonna turn me into a monster a little bit. I'm not gonna go die. It's like, if you don't treat me right, I might just beat you the fuck up, and I might leave the house. You know, I might leave the house with the screws from your dining room set, you know, the food storage containers, your doorknobs, maybe the brakes from your car, the laces from your shoes. You know, nothing too serious. No, something light like that. Just Nothing too much. You know, I might take the wraps off your bread. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, now, don't get me wrong. Or do. I really don't. Never. Get a fuck. Splitting the dinner bill to me is some broke shit. Like, you saying, oh, if you can't split the bill, you must be broke. Oh, stay at home. Don't come. But answer me this. And be honest when I say it. Which sound more broke to you? Me ordering paying for everything I order, everything I ate and drank, right? Or me eating everything that I paid, me eating everything that I ordered and drank, and then looking to the next bitch to help me pay for it. What sound more broke to you? I would never ask my friend to do that. We all eat differently. What if my friend over here eat like they daddy? They order everything on me once or twice. Then my friend over here eat like a hamster. And then me, bitch, I like to get a $225. If my friend shit is $150,000, my shit $26.73, this bitch, shit, 75 cents. All she got was lettuce and steamed carrots. Why am I expecting her to go half with me? Why does she need to pay $13? Why do me and her need to go half with this friend? Why do we need to split the bill three ways when you eat more than me and I'm eating more than my the last friend? It don't make nothing close to sense, bitch. You stay at home. If you can't afford your own meal, you can't afford your own drink, you can't afford your own appetizers, you can't afford your own dessert, you stay at home, baby, and I mean it. You drink what I point out, they don't make nothing close to sense to me. Don't come out with me if you're a broke bitch. That's all I'm saying. I'm a broke bitch. Now, when I was younger, or whatever, stuff like that, right, I used to think that the problem that gays and straight couldn't get along is because of the straight dudes. You know, they're insecure. You know, they're not secure in their sexuality. You know, this, that, third, fourth, and fifth. I mean, it is some. But I learned, too, that gays are also the problem. That gays and girls, it's like, oh, why can't straights get along with gays? Why can't gays and straights just be friends? No, they don't make you gay. But every time you see a straight dude trying to be friends with a gay dude, you automatically assuming that he DL, that he gay, that he like gay boys. So it's like, what do y'all really want? Either y'all want us to be cool with each other, or y'all don't. You're gonna point out, and then some of y'all, I'm a part of y'all, not gonna lie. Some of y'all think that when a straight dude is nice to y'all, that he automatically wants y'all. They happen to be before, I'm not gonna lie. Messed up a good friendship. That's cool. That's what they're done with. Even if he is gay, or you think he is the, you think he do want you, don't make the first move. Cause you know, you could miss read. He could really just like not give a fuck, and he might just treat you like, you know, you. He might play with you a little bit, you know, play around. Now, you can't take it too far with playing gay. I'm not going to lie. Like, some of y'all do be taking it too far. And that's what make a bitch think y'all is gay. Some of y'all just need to dally back. Just dally back on the gay jokes. You know what I'm saying? That's all I'm going to say. Just dally back a little bit. And another thing, don't ask a gay boy where the hoes is. Because mentally, in our mind, you're not looking for the hoes. You're looking for us. We the hoes. We are the hoes. And we like the hoes that y'all looking for. Because, baby, one thing about me, when a straight dude asks me, oh, where the hoes at? Right here. I'm the head of the hoes. I lead the hoes. You see this pack of hoes behind me? I'm the head. I'm the hoe leader. So, like, don't ask me where the hoes at. Just go find your hoes yourself, because I'm thinking that you're looking for me. You want me. You want this hoe. You don't want the other hoes. You want this hoe. And that's what I'm going to say. That's how I'm going to feel. So, either ask somebody else where the hoes at or find them yourself. You know what I'm saying? Maybe ask Inspector Gadget. One thing that really bothers me, and I just can't shake it for no reason, and it's really unnecessary, I'm not going to lie. But one thing that really bothers me is in Lil Freak, with Nicki Minaj and Usher, Nicki Minaj names all the reindeer except Rudolph. How that work? They don't make nothing close sense to me. Like, you name majority of the reindeer, if not all, but you left off the most important one. You left out the leader of the group, like the star that everybody be checking for. That's like leaving Michael out the Jackson 5. Leaving Normani out of Fifth Harmony. Beyonce out of Destiny Child. That's like leaving me out my daddy kids. That shit don't make nothing close to sense. Nikki, why would you say all this about these reindeer and not include Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer? I've been mad at you ever since. That's one of my favorite verses about you, though. But that's like, I just can't even get over the fact that you left out reindeer, Rudolph like that. I mean, I be beefing with you sometimes. Until the song come on, I still rap it with my full chest. But when I'm not hearing it, I'm mad at you. Somebody said that the best things in life were free, but we can't steal. Why would you lie? Well, y'all, that's all for this video. I hope y'all enjoyed it, you know, or whatever and stuff like that. Let me see what I'm supposed to say. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, you know, share. Tell your grandparents, tell your mama, tell your daddy, tell your brother, tell your sister, tell your cousin, tell your uncle, tell your auntie, tell your niece, tell your best friend, tell your worst enemy that, excuse me, don't tell them that Sweet Baby Red is on YouTube and, you know, this where it's at, and they don't want to miss out. Until next time. Oh, and comment something else that y'all would like me to do. I'm struggling like a motherfucker. I'm not gonna lie, I'm telling the truth. Comment some more videos that y'all would like to see me do. I'm gonna start comment some games. Somebody said they want to see me. They want me to stream new, trying out new games. So comment some games that y'all would like me to try out. I got PlayStation 4, not no 5, not no Xbox. I'm not no Xbox type of bitch. I'm not no 5 type of bitch because I barely play the game. So why would I buy 5 if I barely play my 4? You joking the point out? So yeah, that's it for that video. I just want to say, be good. If you can't be good at it. Good night, sleep tight, and don't let the broke boys pipe.